remember when I cried for mercy. I was welcome with open arms.
Well, good evening. We are glad you are here today. My name is Pastor Jeremy Higdon. I'm the pastor of Oasis Church here. And one of our desires as a church is to realize that we don't exist just for us, that we actually exist for the community around us. And we also have a value that we believe that we are for the capital C church. We believe if there are churches around us in Jacksonville and North Florida and around the world that likewise are following Christ, likewise believe the Word of God is actually the Word of God, it's true from a God for us to follow and to learn more of who He is, then we believe that as churches, we're on the same team. And so we want to do whatever we can to work together, to celebrate what God is doing in communities, in cities, and what He's doing around the world. Because we do believe that God is alive and active and working around the world. So that's who we are here to celebrate and to recognize once again. So as Oasis Church, we are honored to host Monica Dedmon tonight in this concert to realize again what God is doing in her life. Actually, what God is doing in all of our lives, especially around this time of year. It's a special understanding for us to pause and to reflect and to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So I'm going to pray for us, and then we're going to introduce some people and give some instructions for us as well. So if you would, let's just go ahead and pray. Father God, we thank you again for who you are. God, we thank you, Lord, that you're the one who has called us even to a moment like this. Lord, that nothing happens by accident, that you are in charge and in control of every big and small and seemingly insignificant detail of our lives, God. We believe that you are actively involved in that. And so, Father, as you are writing the story in our lives, we pause and reflect about where you have brought us from. And God, every single one of us has a story that has a past to it, because that's the reality of life. There's a past and a present and a future. And so, God, as we look back, we reflect and we thank you, Lord, from where you brought us. And we recognize where we're at right now, Lord, and we look ahead to what you have for us next. And we believe, again, that you're the one who's actively writing the story of our lives, that you're the one who gives us purpose, that you're the one who shows us what you desire for us to be. And, Lord, you give us the ability to live that out in your name. And so, Father, as we're here right now, we ask that you would turn this place into a worship environment, God, that we would once again meet with you and connect with you and have our hearts aligned with your heart, God. We thank you again for who you are. God, we thank you once again that you're here in this place with us. May you be honored by what happens here tonight. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Well, since we are filming this and streaming this online, we do encourage those who are in attendance, make sure your cell phone is set to vibrate. We don't want to be a distraction to those, not only those who are here, but to those who are joining us literally around the world. And so speaking around the world, I want to introduce Mike Aloia. He is the president and CEO of American Hearts Radio, and he's going to share his story of what God has been doing in his life up to and including this very moment. So if you would, let's do a warm welcome for Mike Aloia.
Thank you, Pastor Jerry. I want to say thank God for all of us being here tonight. And, you know, this is a time of the season of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And Jesus taught us to love each other, love and compassion. That's what American Hearts Radio is. We're a network of people built by the people, for the people, to bring the hearts of the world together. I want to thank my great friend, Miss Monica Dedmon, for coming out tonight to perform for us. Let's give her a big round of applause. An amazing singer, an amazing person, and just an amazing human being. I am so humbled to be here tonight, knowing where I've been. This is our first annual community outreach concert. And this was a vision that God gave me, and I shared with Monica, and she had the same vision in her heart. So the Lord brought us together to begin a wonderful journey to where we can take this nationally to every community and every city and state I know one thing, in every city and state and every neighborhood you drive in, one of the first things you see is a sign that says Crime Watch. I believe there should be a sign above the Crime Watch that says Community Outreach, Sanctuary, where those that are lost, troubled, strung out on drugs, out there prostituting, shooting up heroin, lost and lonely in a trap. This is an epidemic. There's millions of people out there that are suffering right now from drug addiction, alcoholism, and many, many other things. There's not enough love and compassion in the communities. And that's what American Hearts Radio wants to do, and this is going to be our launching pad to try to make this happen through the power and grace of my Almighty Father, God, and Lord Jesus Christ. We've got to come together as people, as human beings, and reach out to each other. On my way here, I took a friend of mine, Britt. She's got heroin addiction and cocaine. She picks at her face so bad, it's so terrible. I've had to take her to the doctor several times. She's trying, but she ends up back in the street. It's a process, I know, because I was a drug addict. I was homeless. I did my time in jail. I was looking at 15 years. I did a year and a half and I got out and I was homeless. That feeling when you walk out of that cell block and you walk outside when the judge said time served and I smelt that freedom and that air hit me. That's the same freedom you feel when you're free from drugs, when you're free from that bondage. And I didn't get where I am by myself, and not just with the power of the Almighty. I got where I'm at today because of people believing in me, people believing in the vision and believing that, hey, you know, this kid's got something. Now, it's my job, as long as I'm here on earth, to make a difference for my children, my grandchildren, and millions of families. And I believe with all my heart that what we're doing here today is going to become a legacy to where I want to see those signs in every neighborhood, community outreach. Let's build sanctuaries built by the people, for the people, from the communities, where they can come in and say, hey man, lay down, get something to eat, don't worry about it. Offer prayer, offer Christian values, offer opportunity, offer re-education. Offer a home, an opportunity to rebuild your life. There's a lot of people out there, man, that need help. We're living in some crazy times. I guess God chose a real crazy, wild, rock and roll guy to bring a bunch of crazy, wild people together in the name of Jesus to make a difference in this crazy world. Thank you, Father, for this moment in my life, and I thank you for all these people here. I want to wish you all a wonderful Merry Christmas. If you know somebody out there that's hurting, a son, a daughter, a nephew, a grandson, anything, granddaughter, that needs help, man, don't judge them. Don't label them. Don't shun them. Offer a hand and say, hey, man, I love you. You're going to be all right. You got a purpose in life. That's what they don't teach us in school. We each have a purpose. And our purpose right now is to entertain you people. We've got Monica Dedmon that is going to touch your soul with some amazing music. Let's take this music into the streets. Let's have block parties in the community outreach centers. These sanctuaries have homes where neighborhoods open up their homes and we can set up outside and food and let the people that are lost come, man. Listen to the music. Let's bring the communities together. Bring the hearts of the world together. In the name of Jesus Christ. My name is Mike Aloia. Thank you so much for being here. Merry Christmas. That's my time. Rock and roll.
I'm so sorry. So sorry. I got so
going on, sir? Martha Johnson, Monica's mom's here. Come here. Get over here. Let's give her a big round of applause. She's going to have her own ministry series on our web television network, and we are going to produce it because we believe in Martha Johnson and Monica.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you, everybody, for coming. What a joy. What a privilege, what an honor. Like he said, it's an epidemic. And a lot of, thank God, we're part of a church that genuinely cares for the homeless, for the downtrodden, the people think they're worthless. But that's who Jesus Christ died for. I once was lost and now I'm found. And you know, like my daughter always says, people don't ask, or they don't say to their mom, Mom, I think I want to be a drug addict when I grow up. It's a hold that the enemy has on people. It's an enemy. It's evil, and it's running rampant across the globe. But we're ambassadors of Christ. We're ambassadors of our Heavenly Father. We must be about our Father's business. I'm so thankful for Mike offering my daughter the privilege and the honor of going across the globe. I want to thank Brother Jeremy for opening up this beautiful church. Isn't it beautiful?
Yes.
Beautiful. I hope and pray that, I was telling Monica, it doesn't matter if it's one or 1,001 here. Someone's going to be touched. And if it's not someone touched here, which I know you're going to be touched. But if it's somebody in Tokyo, then let it be. So with great honor, with great privilege, I love this girl. From the first time I laid eyes on her. And we've been best friends ever since. She's precious. She's got a precious spirit. Thank God she has a home church that is backing her up. She has people that believe in them. And like Mike said, all you need is somebody to believe in you. But you know who believes in you? Your Father, Jesus Christ. And if you've got Father God, Jesus Christ, if you've got the Lord and Savior in your life on your corner, then you've got it everything. Amen, Mike?
Amen, baby.
You've got everything because he died for you. He died for you. He died for you. And he died because he loves you. And he welcomes you with open arms. So pick up that head, lift it high. Because the God that made the heaven and earth made you and I. And we want to praise his name. And we want to lift his name up high tonight. Because Jesus said it best, if I be lifted up, I'm going to draw all men to me. And what a wonderful thing to be drawn by the Savior. So now without further ado, it's my honor, my privilege, and my pleasure to introduce my daughter, Monica Dedmon.
Hello, I'm Monica Dedmon.
That was some very touching words, Mike. Very touching words, very touching testimony. I truly appreciate it.
I'm going to start out this set with a song titled, Face the Father Before I Face the Day. What I try to do on a daily basis is when my eyeballs open, I thank Jesus Christ. No matter how I may be feeling, no matter what is going on, I thank my Father for giving me life and giving me breath and setting me free. I bring out my journal, I write my prayers, and I pray for God's will to be done, not mine. So this song is called Face the Father Before I Face the Day. The sun will rise, the moon will fall. With my eyes awake, I pray that I will call on you, my Lord. All the days must light, may a person in me be your child. So I pray to God. Face the day, God enough for me with joy and everlasting peace, so that I may endure the hour of my life with hope, only through the power of the Holy. Title track of my album, Deep Calls to Deep. Psalms 42:7. Deep calls to deep at the sound of your waterfalls. All your waves and your breakers have rolled over me. And I take that to interpret that the depths of our Heavenly Father, His Spirit, is calling to the depths of our spirit. His Spirit calls our spirit. And this is actually the first song that I wrote on the album. And I was sitting on my back patio. And I'm a moderate rhythm guitar player at best. And I lifted up my guitar and I said, "Dear God, give me the words so that they may touch someone's heart. Give me the chords, give me the melody, and I will give it all back to you." And that's exactly what I did. While I was writing in my journal the words, God spoke to me, and that may sound odd to some, but Jesus said, "My sheep know the sound of my voice." And he said, write these words down. So I had my pen and paper. I'm like, okay, I'm ready. He goes, no, write these words down. I'm like, okay, write these words down. Said your father. Okay, said your father. So all these words are inspired by him, from him, to us. So give God the glory. A year ago, and I got it because I held Because I held on, and I thank God in advance. I thank God in advance for my healing. He touched me, and He healed me. He pulled me through the ringer first, but that's okay, because whatever it takes for Him to get me, that's all right by me, because He got me. I'm so thankful that I'm saved by the precious blood of Jesus Christ Almighty. I'm a child of the Most High Living God. Man, I tell you what, if it wasn't for the whole sweet Holy Spirit, my Father God, Jesus Christ, and my beautiful mother, I would not have been able to make it through. This song is for encouragement. Sweet Holy Spirit. Intended for us to have a wonderful, fully abundant life while we're here on earth. Heaven is great. Can't wait to get there and all. But I really want to enjoy my life while I'm here, right?
Yeah.
He wants to give us His joy, His peace, His love, his comfort, oh my God, his peace and his comfort are unsurpassable. And this song is called Before Heaven. Before heaven, promise my tears will be wiped away. Hear my Father, lay our soul in his living place before heaven. While we're living a broken life to serve our Savior, while we're not straight from trouble and strife before heaven. Cocktail and light a cigarette or a joint or whatever, and you just kick back and you drink that cocktail. And you're like, ugh. Well, that is nothing compared to the peace of Jesus Christ can give you. Absolutely nothing. The peace of God is unfathomable, unsurpassable. And when I say I drank a lot, I drank a lot. I think I was in a contest to see who could drink the most, who could spend the most money on the worst thing possible. But this song, it's called Never Thirst Again. Jesus was speaking to the Samaritan woman who came to the well. And he said, "Woman, if you drink of the water that I shall give you, you will never thirst again." And I've read that scripture 20 times or so, several times. And it finally just hit home, because his water was his abundant love, his abundant peace, his abundant joy. And you know, whenever you're drinking, whenever you're doing drugs, all you're really looking for is a little bit of peace, a little bit of resemblance of peace. And God, I started drinking when I was 13 years old. And that was 30 years ago. It's a long time. But I was just trying to find some peace. And then I just got tired of living life my way. And I called out and I said, "Father God, give me this water so that I may never thirst again." And I'm so happy he gave me this water. He gave me his water. And I'm so very thankful. I've never been happier in my life. There isn't nothing on the planet you can purchase that gives you the peace and happiness that I have dwelling in my heart, that he gives so freely. I love you all.
So patiently.
gave me his order. My God, how we forfeit such peace trying to obtain it. This next song is called Saving for Myself, which is exactly what it is. Now I drank enough whiskey to float a battleship around. That's not funny, that's just lyrics to a Leonard Skinner song. But it wasn't funny. I could drink a case of beer and a bottle of Crown by myself in a single night and wonder why everybody else has gone to sleep. That's a lot of alcohol in here, buddy. It's a wonder that I'm physically, it's a wonder that I didn't kill myself inadvertently. And there's only one reason for that, and his name is Jesus Christ, the Lord and my Savior. I was talking to a friend of mine yesterday, and I was at a get-together, and I was plastered. Thank God I wasn't never like a loud-mouth belligerent individual. Or maybe it was, I don't know. But anyway, I don't remember this, but we were standing out by a pool deck, and I had stepped back into the pool, and I'd fallen into the pool, and I don't remember, and I was just down at the bottom not doing anything, and my buddy's husband had to dive in to get me, because I was awake. I had passed out from drinking. Thank you, Jesus, indeed. Where you are, I will be with you. And he was with me that night. My friend physically saved my life, but Jesus Christ ultimately saved my life. I've seen so many people, I've forgotten how many people I've seen die. Drug addiction, alcohol poisoning. And I just really, 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 God would speak to me. Okay, it's time for you to quit drinking while I got my birthday. Well, then here comes Valentine's. Well, you're going to St. Patrick's Day. There's always a different reason for me to keep on drinking. And then I finally just said, after waking up, Christmas Day last year was the last time I drank. And it was also the last time that I woke up drowning on my vomit. And unfortunately, it wasn't the first time. But thank you, Jesus Christ, it was the last time. And if you think we're half a second, this is easy. Just stand up here and open yourself up. Not just musically as an artist, but to tell your testimony. It's not easy, but I'm not trying to do a thing that is easy. I'm trying to do a thing that is very difficult because people need to hear it. People need to be aware. And people need to have compassion. So many people say, why don't you just get over it? Why don't you just stop? Why don't you just quit? Well, it's not that easy. But I'm very thankful that I had a great support system, a great church, a loving mother who never, ever, ever judged me, no matter what shenanigans I was doing. The song is called Saving for Myself.
Thank you.
friends have died or gone. You see, this song is for the individual. I'm just going to lay it out like Jesus would. This song is for the Pharisee and the hypocrite. This song is for the people that call themselves Christians but have zero love in their heart, zero compassion. They speak these lovely, beautiful words, but deep down in their heart, they are cankerous, evil individuals. And like David, I say on a daily basis, dear God, search my heart and find that there be no evil in my heart. And I do have, I'm not walking on water yet, you guys, don't get me wrong, but I'm not where I was. I'm not where I want to be either. I've got some issues that I still need working with. Those are some unanswered prayers. I'm sure we all have unanswered prayers. But this song is called What Do You See?
Mm-hmm.
See the beginning, but this isn't the end. This is only the beginning. God has created a good work in me, and I thank God for American Hearts Radio for bringing me into their family, and I thank Trevor and Eileen Bild from Ordinary to Extraordinary Life Productions to be here with us. Thank you guys so much. This song is more of a fun tune. Everybody can relate to it. If you grew up in Jacksonville or anywhere in Florida, really, cruising up A1A, gonna have a good time. So everybody sing with me. Not too loud, we're videoing. I'm just kidding. No, I'm not.
Rolling down Hector Drive, cruising down that same old line. If I had a nickel for every time I see those same old signs, I'd be a millionaire today if I ever could and reach a sea. All the boats on the water, Lord, how it stimulates me. All the dunes in the old days, we'd run around and laugh all day till the drive of the truck is a good time or two. At night we build a big old fire, here with the warmth we desire, kick it back with the moon to sing in our favorite tunes. They won't ever run our way. Feeling fine, sunshine. They won't ever run away, leaving our struggles far behind. The next day started the same. Got together with the whole gang. Someday we knew we had to borrow some time to catch a ride. Maybe a Mustang, maybe a van. And that day it didn't matter then, because we knew we had to catch the tide, ride that perfect line. It's time to run through the water, feel the sun on my skin. Now I'm seeing all the beauty that my mama seen back then. We paddle out, we paddle far out with the sun rising into the stars. I thank the good Lord the next day he gave me a chance to start again. They won't ever run away. Feeling fine, sunshine. They won't ever run away, leaving our troubles far behind. They won't ever run away. Feeling fine, sunshine.
A couple days ago. Man, I love cruising down A1A. Man, I really wish I had a band behind me so I can take this thing off and move around. Well, that's all right. Next time. God's going to send me some anointed musicians who are not full of themselves, if that's possible. Just kidding. It's not possible. I'm just kidding.
No, I'm not.
I'm kidding. Anyway, enough of that. This song is called Your Cries Have Awoken the Master. Marlene Dietrich, I'm a huge classic film fan, and Marlene Dietrich said, it's the friends you can call at 4 a.m. that matter. Well, you just don't want to call people at 4 a.m. Because the first thing, when somebody calls me at 6 a.m, I'm like, who's dead? What's wrong? You know, don't want to freak anybody out. You don't want to put anybody out. But there is a man that you can call 24/7, 365 days a year. His name is Jesus Christ Almighty, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And I am so thankful that he heard my cry in the middle of the night at 4 a.m, pacing, thanking God in advance. Dear God, I know you're going to remove this from me. I know you're going to heal me. I don't see it now. I don't feel it now, but I'm thanking you in advance. And I believe quite wholeheartedly that he inhabits the praise of his children. Whenever you, when you believe and have faith without seeing anything yet, he will move swiftly for you. And he is no respecter of person. What he did for me, he will do for you. cross and calm sea when Jesus, the disciples were getting constant. The wind started violently blowing. He fell asleep in the stern. Does he not care that we perish? We're helpless and we're so afraid. Said them when we woke up, where is your faith? 'Cause you prayed all night, 'cause you held.
So many of us are in prison, but prison doesn't necessarily have to be
behind bars. I was in prison, but I could have gotten out any time I want to. But it doesn't really matter. Better late than never, right?
Yeah.
But I'm not late. I'm right on time as far as I'm concerned. This song is called Grace in a Prison Place. It's not easy being the only one in the room that's ever been in prison. Little did they know. Thank you, God, for your grace and your mercy. And I just want to say that God will be with you. Whenever you call out to him and you need help, he will be with you. But you actually have to be the individual who steps out in faith. You have to make a choice to make a difference in your life. You've read the literature, you've heard the word, but it's your choice. He loves us so much that he gives us a free will. I give you life and I give you death. You choose. It's our choice. He will be with us to help us through our desperate times. It took me 3 months for me to get over my detoxification process. And it was the worst time of my life. It was physically, utterly, completely horrible and horrific. It was awful. And my mother was there by my side, praying and praying and praying until she didn't know what else to pray, but watching me go into convulsions. Vomit. I'm not even going to try to make it a pretty thing, because it's not. But I am so thankful. Jesus Christ holds the keys to heaven and earth, and he holds the keys to my peace. And I'm thankful. But I had to make the steps. He was there to help me. But I had to choose. I had to choose not to pick up that drink. I had to choose not to pick up that so easily to pop pill. I had to choose. He was with me, but it was up to me. So I thank him for giving me the strength to do it. Through Christ, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Once alone, when I was 17, there I was, stood in misery. Once alone, in the prison cell, when my soul was bound for hell. Yes, my soul's bound for hell.
Thank you, Jesus.
Well, as I sit in my prison so cold, I often wonder, is there hope for my soul? But in that moment of gloom and despair, somehow I knew somebody cared. His name is Jesus, and in a prison place, amazing grace, how sweet the sound.
Chest, and you just got, man, I just gotta get this off my chest. Just imagine the brass sections right there, four or five backup singers right over there, three or four guitar players. Imagine all that when I say this. King Jesus, why don't you hear me when I pray? Opportunity. Thank you, Pastor Jeremy Higdon. Thank you, Oasis Church, for allowing us to have this function here. Thank you so very much. I appreciate all of you, and I love you all very much. You have a lovely, wonderful evening, and we are going to have an awesome after-show party. Thank you, and God bless. Thank you for coming.